Hello students, in this session we'll be studying about the five kingdom classification system in detail. Before we begin up with that, in the last session we discussed about the scientific name of an organism, but there are a few rules which you should keep in mind while writing the scientific name of any organism. In scientific name, always remember the genus will be written in capital. The first letter of genus will be written in capital letters. So, say for example, we take Homo sapiens, that is the scientific name of humans, the word Homo, the H of Homo will be capital. Rest everything will be in small letters. So, the first letter of genus will be capital. Now, coming up to the species. So, for the species, the first letter will be small. So for the humans, the species name is sapiens. So it will be like this, Homo sapiens. This is the way we are supposed to write the scientific name of an organism. Now, if you are writing it on paper, you need to underline this. So this is the second rule while writing. Underline the genus and species. The third rule is, if the scientific names are being typed, so while typing it has to be, the text needs to be in italics. So these are just three rules which you should keep in mind while writing the scientific name of any organism. Same way, similarly, you can even write it for other organisms. Say for example, mango plant. So it is Mangifera indica. Let's take one more example. Lion. So the scientific name of lion is Panthera leo. So this is the way you are supposed to write. Now let's move on further with the next part of classification, that is five kingdom classification. As discussed earlier, the five kingdom classification was given up by the scientist Robert Whittaker. Robert Whittaker gave us five kingdoms in which there was space for the prokaryotes, also there was space for the eukaryotes, and further the eukaryotes were divided into unicellular eukaryotes and multicellular eukaryotes. So let's have a look at the classification what Robert Whittaker gave us. So if you see, the living organisms, they were divided into two categories. First is the prokaryotes, which is the primitive ones, and the next what we have is the eukaryotes. Further, the eukaryotes were divided into two categories, unicellular eukaryotes and multicellular eukaryotes. Now, the unicellular eukaryotes, they were called as protista, and the prokaryotes, they were called as monera. So we have discussed two kingdoms, that is the kingdom monera and kingdom protista. Further coming to the multicellular organisms, further in multicellular organisms, there were organisms who were having cell wall and few were without cell wall. So further, the multicellular is divided into two parts, organisms with cell wall and organisms without cell wall. So the organisms with cell wall were further divided into two categories, that is the kingdom fungi and the kingdom plant. So two categories of organisms with cell wall, kingdom fungi and kingdom plantae. And finally coming up with this part, which is the multicellular eukaryotes without a cell wall, that is kingdom animalia. So this is the overall classification which Robert Whittaker gave us. So the basis of classification was the body design, the mode of nutrition of organisms, and also their presence or absence of cell wall. Hello students, now we will be studying about the five kingdoms in detail. So let us begin with the first kingdom, Kingdom Monera. The Kingdom Monera is the first kingdom which will include all unicellular prokaryotes. So we have unicellular organisms, and also these organisms are prokaryotes. So when I say the word prokaryotes, it means that these organisms do not have a well-defined nucleus. If you have a look at the diagram, here in the diagram, the prokaryote, which is shown over here, is an example of a bacteria. So the bacterial cell will not have a well-defined nucleus, that is, the nuclear membrane is absent around the DNA molecule. So their genetic material just lies in the cytoplasm like this. Also, the monerans, they have a cell wall around themselves. The cell wall is made up of material called as peptidoglycan. The word peptidoglycan is made up of two words, and it is a complex molecule. The peptido means the protein part, and glycan means the carbohydrate part. So peptidoglycan is the material which is forming the cell wall of monerans. Also, the most important thing, they are all unicellular organisms. So these unicellular organisms, one single cell is performing all the functions. The examples of monerans will include all bacteria, all lactobacillus. Also, it will include cyanobacteria, which is the blue-green bacteria, and there are many more. Now, let's move on with the next kingdom, Kingdom Protista. The Kingdom Protista is also called as Protoctista. This kingdom will include all unicellular organisms, but they will be eukaryotes. So when I say eukaryotes, it means that these organisms have a well-defined nucleus around them. The DNA material will be enveloped in a nuclear membrane. Also, they will have all membrane-bound cell organelles like the mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum. Also, they will have ribosomes. So this is about the protista. Also, the unicellular organisms, they will have only one single cell performing all the different functions. They are the most primitive ones, and hence the name is given as protista. This kingdom will include all organisms which are like amoeba, paramecium, euglena, chlamydomonas. Now, few organisms over here, they are autotrophic also, like the chlamydomonas, and few organisms are heterotrophic also, like the amoeba, paramecium, and euglena. This is all we have to study about the protista kingdom. Now, let us move further with the next kingdom, Kingdom Fungi. The kingdom Fungi will include all the funguses which are present. Kingdom Fungi is unicellular or multicellular. So the organisms belonging to this category, they can be either unicellular or they can be multicellular eukaryotes. Very important. They are all included in the category of eukaryotes. So few fungi which we have, they are unicellular, like the yeast cells. Yes, yeast cells are the ones which are used for making bread and cakes. And the multicellular funguses which we have, they are like penicillium, mushrooms, they are all multicellular eukaryotes. Again, the word eukaryote suggests they all have a membrane-bound nucleus. Now, the most important thing which I had said during classification, fungi are included under cell wall containing eukaryotes. So, the cell wall material of fungi is not like the plants, which is cellulose. The cell wall of funguses is made up of a complex carbohydrate which is called as chitin. Chitin is the material which is very tough, and it will form a cell wall around these funguses. So if we have a look at the structure of a fungus, the structure of a fungus suggests they are having mycelium. Mycelium means thread-like structures. So there are various thread-like structures which are interwoven over each other. Each thread is called as hyphae. So mycelium is a bunch of hyphae. Now, also there is one more important thing. Their cytoplasm is continuous and they have various nucleuses in them. Now, mushrooms. Let's take example about the mushrooms. Mushrooms, they are two types of mushrooms. Ones which are edible and the ones which are non-edible ones. The edible ones include the white button mushroom and the non-edible ones, there are various mushrooms. Now, let's move on with the further examples of the class fungi. In fungi, we have one more important fungus, which is the penicillium. Penicillium notatum is the fungus from which we get the antibiotic penicillin. Penicillin is the first antibiotic which was ever made. The next examples of funguses which we have is the yeast cell, which I have already mentioned where they are used. There is also a lot of commercial applications over it. So this is what we have to study about Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista and Kingdom Fungi. In the next session, we'll be focusing more on Kingdom Plantae and Kingdom Animalia.